If I ever need to create a wiring diagram for a data logger station that is already programmed and making measurements, but no wiring documentation is available, I have a few ways of doing this. In this video, I'll show how to add comments to a CRBasic program to document the wiring for my current system. The CRBasic Editor is a PC-compatible software application for writing data logger programs in the Campbell Scientific CRBasic programming language. CRBasic is included in LoggerNet and PC400 software, and may also be downloaded as a free standalone installation. The videos and tutorials section of the CRBasic webpage on the Campbell Scientific website has several tutorial videos for anyone unfamiliar with CRBasic. Before I can create a wiring diagram to match an existing program, I need to know what sensors are connected to the data logger and the colors of the individual sensor wires. I also need to know which terminal on the wiring panel each wire is connected to. If that information is not available, I may need to make a site visit to take notes and photographs of the system. Ideally, information about the sensors and wiring is in the notes for the data logger program, which can be downloaded using the Retrieve Program button in PC400 or the LoggerNet Connect screen. Sometimes the program notes don't contain that information, but there are clues in the variable names, program instructions, and data field names that can help me deduce the wiring. I'll cover that in this video. Program notes or comments can be inserted into the program by preceding the text with a single quote. When the program is compiled, the data logger compiler will ignore any text that is preceded by the single quote. A comment can be placed at the beginning of a line, or it can be placed after a line of program code. If syntax highlighting is enabled, commented text will appear formatted differently than other lines of code. Usually, it's best to create a section of program notes at the top of the program to document wiring information. In this example, I've retrieved a working program from my data logger, but there are no wiring notes. This is because the program was sent in compressed form, with the notes stripped out to conserve data logger memory. To make the program more readable, I press Ctrl-I to rebuild the indentation. Then I press Return to add blank lines between the different sections of the program. Finally, I'll return to the top of the program and create a section called Wiring Here, starting with a single quote. Adding bookmarks to my CRBasic program can be very useful when I need to move quickly from one part of the program to another. I can insert, delete, and move between bookmarks with the options under Bookmarks in the Go To menu. To save time, I will use the keystrokes Ctrl-T to insert or delete a bookmark, Ctrl-D to move down to the next bookmark, and Ctrl-U to move up to the previous bookmark. I'll start by pressing Ctrl-T here at the top of the program where I want to enter wiring information. Then scroll down to the measurement section of the program where wiring information may be found and enter Ctrl-T again to create another bookmark. I already know that one of the sensors connected to my data logger is a CS301 pyranometer, but I don't know where it's connected. I can go to the sensor manual or web page to find out what type of output signal is returned by the CS301. This will help me find the measurement instruction in the program for that sensor, and from there I can learn which channel it's connected to. In this case, the specifications on the CS301 web page tell me that the sensor output range is 0 to 400 millivolts. So I know that there must be a single-ended or differential voltage instruction in the program to measure the CS301. Looking at the program, I see a volt SE instruction. I right-click on the instruction name to open the sensor configuration window. The destination variable name is SLRW, which could mean solar radiation in watts, so this seems to be the code for the CS301. The parameter called SCCHAN is the single-ended channel number for the voltage measurement. This tells me the sensor signal wire is connected to single-ended channel 1. I'll add program notes here with that information. Every single-ended voltage signal has a signal reference wire that connects to analog ground, so I'll add a note for that as well. The last thing I want to include in my wiring documentation is the colors of the sensor wires. If I have a photo of the wiring panel, I can just look at SC1 and see what color the signal wire is. Without a photo, I could check the sensor manual for that information. Here in the CS301 manual, I see the signal wire is white, The signal reference wire is black, and there is also a clear shield wire. I'll add that information to the program notes. Now I'm ready to cut the notes from this section of the program. Use Ctrl-U to move up to the bookmark at the top of the program and paste the notes in the wiring section. If I don't know the sensor model or have a photo of my system, I still might be able to gather some wiring information from the data logger program. For example, when I right-click on this BR half instruction to open the sensor configuration window, I see the destination variable name is winddir, which probably stands for wind direction. So this instruction is probably for measuring a wind vane. The CRBasic help for the BR half half-bridge instruction shows the sensor should have a wire connected to a voltage excitation channel, a wire connected to a single-ended voltage channel, and a wire connected to analog ground. The sensor configuration window tells me that the signal wire connects to single-ended channel SE4, and the excitation wire connects to output voltage channel VX1. The signal reference wire always connects to analog ground. I can add this information to my notes. If I had a photo of the wiring panel, I could look at channels SE4 and VX1 to see what color of wires are connected there. Otherwise, the best I can do is put wire function and location in my wiring notes. The advantages of using CRBasic program notes to document wiring are that notes are a flexible way of recording information that can be tailored to individual preferences, and that the information will be merged with the data logger program and may be accessed at any time in the future by simply retrieving the data logger program.